Shalom, Yasharal. A recent news story caught my attention about a group that was disqualified from the annual Philadelphia Mummers Parade. They were disqualified because they were wearing blackface. Check out this clip.
Would it be the Mummers Day Parade without controversy? A gritty-inspired group was disqualified for wearing blackface. And now, Mayor Jim Kenney says that there could be further consequences. Eyewitness News reporter Matt Petrillo spoke to the group in question. He is live at the convention center with this story. Hi, Matt.
Hey, Jessica. You know, the Philadelphia mayor has a sharp message for those mummers. More on that controversy in a moment. First, take a look behind me. We are at the convention center backstage where these mummers are getting ready to hit the stage and show off their larger-than-life performances. But, of course, the mummers have been working for a year for this, but that's not the case for one group that's been disqualified for wearing blackface, many view as racist.
About that.
So why the blackface?
Because I like
why
it.
Why not?
Yeah, why not? Why not?
These two mummers wearing blackface claim it's only part of their costumes.
It has nothing to do to about being racist to the black person or the white person or the yellow person, whatever. It's our tradition.
The men are affiliated with the Froggy Car Club on 2 Street in South Philly. The group's theme this year is based off gritty. Why not do orange face or any other color other than a black face?
What difference does it make?
I ain't did a black face in a long time.
But now the city has disqualified the group. Still, thousands of other mummers dance their carefully choreographed routines without all black face paint. Many wearing lots of colorful costumes, strutting their stuff down JFK Boulevard in Center City, welcoming 2020.
Happy New Year!
There were plenty of crowd pleasers today, like lobsters, clowns, and more.
It's amazing. It's super cool.
I love seeing everybody dancing and having a fun time.
It's a living tradition.
And as the saying goes, the show must go on. Right now, mummers are taking the stage here at the convention center to see who has the best act. Reporting live in Center City, Matt Petrillo, CBS 3 Eyewitness News.
All right, Matt, thank you.
Now, for most of us, we would see a story like this and get very upset, understandably, because of the racism. And if we're not careful, we'll get caught up in our feelings and allow a story like this to upset us for the rest of the day. The Ruach said, dig a little deeper. And that's just what I did. So when I researched this Mummers Parade, right on encyclopedia.com, this is what I found out. It says this tradition dates back to 400 BC and the Roman festival of Saturnalia. That's right. Most of us are familiar that Saturnalia is the roots of where we get the modern day Christmas holiday or festival. The article goes on to say, this tradition is where Latin laborers marched in masks throughout the day. And they engaged in satire and gift exchange. And a big part of the celebration of this new solar year was with merrymaking. In the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 7, verse 4, we are told the heart of the wise is in the house of mourning, but the heart of fools is in the house of merrymaking. As the children of Yahuwah, does this mean we can't have fun or be merry? Of course not. But the heart of a fool is not thinking of doing things that are pleasing to Yahuwah. On the other hand, the heart of a fool is constantly looking to gratify the flesh, constantly living from one party to the next. And that's exactly what Hasatan is doing with the people of the world, having them focus on one pagan celebration to the next. Recently, we had Christmas, then New Year's, and a part of this New Year's, this Mummers Parade. The next one will be Valentine's. You see, Yasharal? These festivals, these worldly festivals, are all about making fools of those in the world. And Hasatan and his agents are laughing at these partygoers as they get drunk on wine and alcohol and dress in drag. It goes even deeper, Yasharal. In case you were wondering, like I did, where this word mummers comes from, it comes from the Greek god Momos. That's right. These people are participating in a parade named after a false Roman deity, Momos. He is said to be the god of satire, mockery, and poetry. And as you can see here, he's depicted as lifting a mask from his face. Hence all the masks that are a part of this parade. But I hope in this short, video, I've unmasked the truth of this celebration and who is behind it. None other than Hasatan and his agents. Please realize, Yasharal, when things like this happen, there's always a spiritual component behind it. And all we have to do is dig a little deeper. We are told in the scriptures to test everything. And it is my hope and prayer that in these last days, we'll be sober-minded. And that more hearts will be turned back to both the written and living Torah. Yah bless.